Hi,
my name is Quentin, 8 years old, primary school from Yumin Primary School.
I'm Quentin, 11 years old, primary 5, also from Yumin Primary School.
For this lesson, it will still be
Techniques of Definite Integral, Chapter 2, Special Function.
So, last few lessons, what we learned?
We've learned about the beta function.
Okay,
so for those beta function, we found out what can we change them into.
So what?
So beta function, we have their formula.
Yes.
We have that we can change them to sine, whatever, and cosine, right?
Yes.
So this time, we'll prove another thing that the beta function can change into.
Like? Gamma
function. So for this, have you ever wondered, beta function change into gamma function?
Yeah.
Does this sound very weird?
Yes, I never.
Because beta function is from 0 to 1, but gamma function is from 0 to infinity. But they can convert.
Convert to each other.
Okay.
So after that, we'll solve this question, okay? After we prove.
Okay. So let's start with this proving. So let me tell you, if you just start with this, it might be quite difficult. So let's start with gammas.
You should not start with beta. I'd like to know how.
So gamma m, what is it?
Gamma m, which is integral from 0 to infinity, x to the power of negative, just kidding. It's okay, but I could say x to the power of negative 1 plus m times e to the power of negative x.
Then?
Dx.
Yes. Then what is gamma n?
Integral from 0 to infinity x to the power of n minus 1. 1 over e to the power of x.
So it's like this, right?
Yeah.
But what if I don't want to write x?
I don't want you. Because the actual u is just this one.
So what can we change it into?
We could change it.
Maybe z?
Anything you want.
So then, wait a second,
why the x?
Then we can just let this z is equal to x squared.
Let me just ask you a question. Why it never changed? Let me just tell you the answer. The answer is, because that just now you change it don't matter, because that just now the variable don't matter, because it's definite integral.
So is it like this?
Yes.
Then after that you can combine these two. Wait, infinity don't stand up.
Infinity, why you change your infinity to an 8 just now?
I made it stood up. So it's like this, okay?
Much better, yeah.
So then, can we try to combine these two? But also you can change this form with a y into here, because the variable doesn't matter. So let's try to times them. SKOE1 times. So when we times them together, we had two twos, right? Which makes here four. Then here is zero all the way to infinity. X to the power of 2m minus 1 e to the power of negative x squared dx. Then integral from 0 to infinity, y to the power of 2n minus 1 e to the power of negative y squared dy. Like this. Then, but wait, isn't this something like iterated integration?
Yes, could we change it to double integration?
Of course, yes.
But how?
So, first let's see. X is from 0 to infinity. Y is from 0 to infinity. That means which quadrant is it in? Which quadrant?
So, first.
Yes, the first quadrant. So this is in the first quadrant. Let me just put these. Wait, can we combine those e's to the power?
Yep.
Then this is in Cartesian coordinates, right?
Yeah.
So what can we change it into?
Polar. Could we?
Of course.
Of course we don't change it to other cylindrical or those spherical.
Because this is 2D.
Not 3D.
So, for this x, what does x become?
So, x become
r times cosine theta, right?
Yep.
Why
will also change it into the same
So what is x squared plus y squared?
X squared plus y squared equals r squared.
Yes.
Not bliss squared.
Then, can I put an R inside?
Yes.
So, 0 all the way to half pi.
Yes.
So what do you get from this? So is this right? More like it?
Yes.
Wait, but this is r from 0 to what?
From 0 to infinity.
So then, these two combine. Wait a second. Is this right?
No.
Then which part is wrong?
Now which part is wrong?
are like this.
But let me just tell you, because that I changed it to another button, but...
But didn't I say I want R inside?
Oh. Because I haven't put the R inside.
So, what is this part?
This part is be
beta what?
A half, 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 half. That's cheating, no half. Gamma, 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 gamma.
Can you write that?
No, just kidding.
Okay, so this is gamma m plus n.
Okay.
So, the beta function m, n, what is this? Read it. Read it.
Gamma m times gamma n over gamma m plus n.
Okay, so you have these. And this is how you prove it, right?
Yes, it's
how it is. So now, can you find this? And just to tell you, even if you change the order, it will still be very hard.
I know. I want to use it. I want to use that.
This? Okay, so that means you convert, right? But just now what I say no is that you straight away solve.
But what if you try to straight away solve? And I will try the other method.
Binomial expansion to the power of 9?
Yes.
So basically there will be 10 terms.
Yes.
So that will be too tired.
Okay, so...
So now you can start.
Okay.
So this question is integral from 0 to 1, x to the power of 9 times 1 minus x, bracket to the power of 11, dx.
Why is it like this?
Well, because this power to here, let's just say this is m, here is m minus 1, n minus 1, so plus 1 back to get that.
Is it like this? Just kidding. Much better.
Okay, because this is gamma 10 times gamma 12 over gamma 22.
Could we simplify?
Let me just tell you, there's something wrong here. Gamma 22 is still 22 factorial. Okay, that's more like it.
Can we just simplify?
Oh, if you want to simplify, you must write out. Okay, which part simplify you want? Yeah, you must write out 21 times 20 times 19 times 18 times 17 times 16 times 15 times 14 times 13 times 12. Then you must write out all those.
Simplify. Again.
Simplify of 9? Are you sure you can do that?
Yeah, at least one of the numbers inside the 9 factorial.
Well, then you must write out everything.
Okay, so that's quite complicated.
Yes, so you just leave your answer like this. But you're given a calculator, you can just try to calculate this out.
Yes. You can just use a normal kind cell phone.
Cell phone?
No, what I mean because that sometimes our phone has calculator mode. Okay?
Okay.
So what are you doing?
Okay, so for this, when you see so big, right? When you try to calculate them out, it might be very difficult.
And if you use this number even more harder, 12 thumbs.
Yes. 12 thumbs were a better one. You put 9, but still 10 thumbs.
Yes. How complicated!
Okay, so in this lesson, are you clear so far?
Yes.
So now do you know what to use?
Yep.
So in the future, what we see, beta function, so hot, just convert it to gamma function.
Yes.
The best way.
Okay, so now we'll end here, okay?
Okay.
What you want to say?
So if you like our videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel.
Stay tuned for more.
And thank you for your...